Good morning, friends. Today we will start with the new topic in the module 1, that is aggregates. Okay. So in this topic we are going to discuss fine aggregate as well as coarse aggregate. In the beginning you understand that for fine aggregates the each particle size generally less than 4.75 mm, and for coarse aggregate these are generally more than this value. So in the for the understanding for the next test what you are going to conduct, if you say fine aggregate, then you should understand that the average particle size, I am telling that average particle size is less than 4.75 mm, and if you are discussing coarse aggregate, generally the average particle size will be more than 4.75 mm. okay, here it is less than, here it is more than. Okay, just so here in the fine aggregate topic we are going to discuss the introduction part. Very important point is properties. We need to understand what are the good properties or the what are the properties of good sand. Okay, next, what type of functions of sand will be doing in concrete or mortar. Okay, we are discussing the functions. Next is impurities part, grading of sand, sieve analysis, zoning, specific gravity, bulking, moisture content. Okay, so these are the test, sieve analysis and specific gravity, bulking, moisture content. These are the test we are going to see, and these are the concepts. Okay, what are these, we will see one by one. Here in the introduction part we are going to see what are the natural sources of sand for the construction purpose, whatever may be the purpose we are using sand. See here, sand means you understand that it is a fine aggregate. So wherever sand comes, no, so you, it is generally understood that it is a fine aggregate. Okay, so here the sand particle consists of small grains of silica. So the major compound or the major thing which is present in sand is SiO2, silicon dioxide. Okay, so how it is formed? How it is formed? Generally sand or fine aggregate, it is formed by the decomposition. It is formed by the decomposition of sandstones. Okay, sandstones due to various effects of weather means maybe wind, maybe friction, maybe river water or water. So external effect means it is going to degrade, decomposition or weathering. So all the three things are possible. So decomposition or weathering effect will produce sand, will produce sand from sandstones. Okay, generally. So here one more is there, crushed stone sand. What do you mean by crushed stone sand? It is obtained from the screenings. So there may be crusher area will be there, so big plants will be there, so big boulders are poured into the crusher one, and crusher will be crushing the big rocks or stones into smaller aggregates. So these are the smaller aggregates. In the same process some dust is also formed, some very very fine particles is also formed. So those things you are separating using screens. Screens is a one thing which separates some particles with the other fine materials. So in the bottom you will get crushed stone sand, you will get crushed stone sand, and in the top you are going to separate what? Coarser aggregates. You are going to separate the coarser aggregate. At the bottom you are going to get fine crushed sand or fine crushed stone sand. Okay, so it is obtained from the screenings left from the crushed stone. So what is the process here? So you are going to take the big rocks into the crushing plant or crusher, big plant into the crusher. So after crushing process, when screening is done, so it will separate a particular size of aggregates on one side. At the bottom the passing material is obtained, and passing is generally size is less than 4.75 mm. So less than 4.75 mm we call it as sand. So we have obtained it from stone crushing, so that is why the name given, crushed stone sand. Okay, so in this one major component is silica. It is obtained from decomposition of sandstones. Apart from that, you can also get a crushed stone sand from crushing aggregates, from the crushing of the aggregates. Okay. So in this one, what we are going to see, natural resources or natural sources, generally where you are getting the natural resources. Okay. Pit sand. What do you mean by pit sand? In any area, if you dig the earth up to certain level, afterwards you are going to get what? Sand. This is also one source, not the full source. It is one type of the source. It is called as pit sand. So you are excavating the earth to get the sand. So that is why the name given pit. So this excavated portion is called as a pits. Pit is nothing but what? You are excavating the earth, no? So that is why the pit sand, the name is given pit sand. So this sand is found as deposits in soil. So you are excavating, so it is found as a deposits in soil. So it is obtained by forming pits. It is obtained by forming pits into the soil. Okay. It is excavated from the depth. It is excavated from a depth of about 1 meter to 2 meter. That's all. 1 meter to 2 meter from the ground level. So pit sand, apart from pit sand, apart from crushed stone, what is the major resource? What is the major source of getting sand? Very important. Everyone knows that from the river banks, you are getting the sand or you are getting the fine aggregate. So that is why the name given river sand. Okay. So this sand is obtained from the banks of river beds, banks or beds of rivers. Okay. So very important source. The river sand consists of fine rounded. Fine rounded means it is not irregular shape. Due to the effect of water continuously, so the surface has become very, very round, very, very smooth. Okay, very, very smooth. So fine rounded grain. Grain is nothing but one particle. Grain is nothing but one particle. Probably due to the mutual attrition under the action of water content. Mutual attrition means what? So there may be in the beginning the angular aggregates will be there. Angular aggregates will be there. So continuously water is flowing. So these two particles and many other particles will continuously comes in contact with each other. In the process, the irregularities will go. Irregularities will go and the particles become smooth, very, very smooth. So it is called as mutual attrition, means what? Rubbing with the each other in the action of water. In the action of water, mutual rubbing, or it's called as mutual attrition, the particles will become very, very fine and very, very rounded. Very, very fine and very, very rounded. Okay. Here, the color of a river is generally white color, is generally white color. As the river sand is usually available in clean condition, generally river sand is in clean condition, it is used for almost all engineering purpose, almost all engineering purpose. The another source is sea sand. You understand that generally for engineering purpose, this sand is not used. This sand is not used. Only for non-engineering purpose, or you can say just filling works, filling the trenches. So there you can use. In the beginning, you understand that sea sand contains salts. Sea sand contains salts. So salts are good for engineering purpose or bad for engineering purpose. Salts are always bad because these absorb moisture from the cement concrete. These absorb moisture from the concrete or mortar. So the total quality will be getting reduced. Total quality will be reduced. If you want to use this sand, then you should thoroughly wash this one. Thoroughly wash this one such that salt content is no more. Salt content is continuously removed, totally removed. So that time you can use for this sea sand for also construction purpose. So here you can understand that this sand is obtained from seashores. This sand is obtained from seashores. This sea sand, like river sand, consists of fine grained particles also. Here the particles are also round. The color of sea sand is brownish color. Color of sea sand is brownish color. So very important here, this sea sand contains salts. This sand contains salts. So these salts attract moisture from the atmosphere. So in atmosphere also moisture is there, in concrete also water is there. So it will attract this one moisture. Such absorption causes dampness. So later you will face the problem of dampness, means continuous moisture is present on the surface. Efflorescence. In the bricks chapter you have seen the efflorescence means what? A brick is there, on that body white patches are appearing. White patches are appearing. For what reason these are appearing? When salts are washed away, salts are washed away, so those things will leave white patches. So that is called as efflorescence. In this one also, if you are using this one for the construction of any brick work or any plaster or any wall, so that time also efflorescence may come, efflorescence may appear. So problem with sea sand is, one is dampness, efflorescence and disintegration. Disintegration means the bonding of the particles, the bonding of the sand, bonding of the cement particles is not going to be in a correct way. So that is the three problems: dampness, efflorescence, disintegration. See, it can however be used, means it can also be used as a local material. Local means what? For only trench filling work, only filling work, not a structural work. When after being thoroughly washed, to remove what? To remove the salts. Three important parameters here: obtained from seashore, it is also fine rounded, light brown color, salts are present. Three problems: dampness, efflorescence, disintegration, as well as if you remove the salt, it can be used as local material. It can be used as local material. Okay. Here we can do the classification of sand. You can use this classification according to size. If the particular particle size, average particle size, if you take 1 kg of any sand or any aggregate, all the particles will not be of same size. One may be big, one may be small. So in the average, if you take, in the average, if you take, the classification can be done. How the classification is done? It can be called as fine, it can be called as coarsey, it can be called as gravelry. Means what? Average size is very less, fine. It is medium to more, coarse. If it is totally larger particles are there, then it is called as gravel or gravelly. So here in this table, you can understand here, passing through a screen with clear openings. Screen means what? There is one instrument may be square or may be round. Here some wires, threaded wires are there. Have you seen the sieves in the lab, sieves in your home also, in kitchen? Okay, generally small particle openings are provided. What are these? These are what? Openings. Okay, so the average size of this opening, here it is mentioned. If that opening is 1.5875 mm and the material is passing through that, material is passing through the sieve, and this sieve size is 1.58 mm, then it is called as fine sand. See here, we are discussing sand itself. We can classify the sand itself. So generally sand is 4.75, less than 4.75. In that portion only, we are again classifying three types. In that portion only, we are again classifying three types. If it is less than 1.58, then we call it as a fine sand. Sand only, here also we can have fine sand, coarse sand. Okay, fine sand is generally less than 1.58, used for plastering work, only for plastering work. If it is 3.175, it is called as coarse sand, used for masonry work. Masonry means brick wall, stone wall or any compound wall, anything using the bricks, stones or blocks. Okay, if the size is itself more than 7.62, then it is called as gravelry sand. Here it is also called as coarse aggregate also, but in the coarse aggregate some portion is sand, some portion is gravel. So that is why we call it as gravelry sand. It is also coming under coarse aggregate. So it is the marginal. It is generally used in concrete work. You understand that in this one, if it is the particle size of sand itself is very very fine, then fine sand. If it is medium, coarse sand. If it is bigger particles, it is called as gravel sand. So sieve means what? Sieve is one instrument where small openings are provided. How? Wires have been sieved there, and such a way that the intersection part is acting as one opening. So this size is nothing but opening size, and opening size itself we called it as sieve size. So is nothing but sieve size is nothing but the opening size of this each gap. Okay, 4.7 sieve means what? In that sieve, the particle opening this opening gap is 4.75. How? Maybe diagonal, maybe dimension. Okay, like that. Okay.